I wish I could make reaction videos, but I was born in 1956. I've heard all these songs. What could I possibly react to?
Hey whippersnappers, Brian here at A Boomer Reacts. Welcome back. If this is your first time here, thanks for checking me out. I listen to rap and hip hop songs using lyric videos, and then I let you know what I thought about them. Today we're doing a poll winner. If you guys aren't getting polls on, you know, your own home feed, go to my page, my channel page, and check out community. There's usually always some polls up. This one was for new artists to my channel, and Slick Rick won with a children's story. Technically, Slick Rick is not brand new to my channel because I did a song called La Di Da Di by Doug E. Fresh and Slick Rick, but this is my first Slick Rick solo. If you're new to my channel, before I listen to the song, I like to do a little history about the person, just get an idea of, you know, where they're at when this song came out. So now we're going to do Slick Rick. Slick Rick, an English-American rapper and record producer, was born Richard Martin Lloyd Walters on January 14, 1965 in the southwest London district of Mitcham to Jamaican parents. He was blinded in the right eye by broken glass as an infant. Oh, yeah, I see his picture here with a patch. I wasn't sure if that was a prop or it's real. And as a baby, wow, that's sad. At age 11, he and his family migrated to the United States, settling in the Baychester area of the Bronx. At a 1984 talent show that he had entered, Rick met beatboxer Doug E. Fresh. Impressed by Rick's talent, Doug made him a member of his Get Fresh crew, using the name MC Ricky D. As a member of Get Fresh crew, he was featured on the single The Show and its even more popular B-side, La Di Da Di, which I reacted to. I really liked it too, especially Slick Rick. I thought just his, you know, his rapping was just so different from anyone else I'd ever heard. In 1986, Slick Rick joined Russell Simmons' Rush Artist Management and became the third artist signed to Def Jam Records, the leading rap and hip hop label at the time. Collaborating with his friend DJ Vance Wright, Slick Rick produced his solo debut, The Great Adventures of Slick Rick, which came out in 1988 on Def Jam. The album was very successful, reaching the number one spot on Billboard's R&B hip-hop chart. It also featured three charting singles, Children's Story, Hey Young World, and Teenage Love. Children's Story, the second single released, reached number five in the Hot R&B Singles, staying there for 19 weeks. Wow, that's a long time. Charted number two on the Hot Rap Tracks, remaining on that chart for 11 weeks. This was the best performing single from The Great Adventures of Slick Rick, and it remains one of the most sampled rap songs of all time. Wow. Good to know. Okay. I'm going to listen to Slick Rick, Children's Story.
You kids get to bed, I get the storybook. Y'all tucked in? Here we go. Once upon a time, not long ago, when people wore pajamas and lived life slow, where laws were stern and justice stood, and people were behaving like they ought to good, there lived a little boy who was misled by another little boy, and this is what he said. Me and you tonight, we're gonna make some cash, robbing old folks and making the dash. They did the job, money came with ease. But one couldn't stop, it's like he had a disease. He robbed another and another, and a sister and a brother. Tried to rob a man who was a DT undercover. The cop grabbed his arm, he started acting erratic. He said,
keep still, boy, no need for static.
Punched him in his belly and he gave him a slap. But little did he know the little boy was strapped. The kid pulled out a gun, he said,
why'd you hit me?
The barrel set straight for the cop's kidney. The cop got scared, the kid he starts to figure,
I'll do years if I pull this trigger.
So he cold dashed and ran around a block. Cop radios into another lady cop. He ran by a tree, there he saw the sister. Shot for the head, he shot back but he missed her. Looked around good and from expectations he decided he'd hit for the subway stations. But she was coming and he made a left. He was running top speed till he was out of breath. Knocked an old man down and swore he killed him. Then he made his move to an abandoned building. Ran up the stairs up to the top floor. Opened up a door there, guess who he saw?
Who?
Dave the dope fiend shooting dope. Who don't know the meaning of water nor soap, he said.
I need bullets, hurry up, run.
The dope fiend brought back a spanking shotgun. He went outside, but there was cops all over. Then he dipped into a car, a stolen Nova. Raced up the block doing 83. Crashed into a tree near university. Escaped alive, though the car was battered. Rat-a-tat-tatted and all the cops scattered. Ran out of bullets and he still had static. Grabbed the pregnant lady and pulled out the automatic. Pointed at her head, he said the gun was full of lead. He told the cops, back off, for honey here's dead. Deep in his heart, he knew he was wrong. So he let the lady go and he starts to run on. Siren sounded, he seemed astounded. And before long, the little boy got surrounded. He dropped his gun, so went the glory. And this is the way I have to end this story. He was only
17.
In a madman's dream, the cop shot the kid. I still hear him scream. This ain't funny, so don't you dare laugh. Just another case about the wrong path. Straight and narrow or your soul gets cast. Good night. Knock him out the box, Rick. Knock him out, Rick.
I'm glad that won the poll because I really liked that. That was great. He's, you know, not that I've done a lot of videos yet. I haven't done over 100 yet. But yeah, he's one of my favorite MCs. He is, you know, so funny in his delivery. And I didn't realize in La Di Da Di, the strong British accent that he has. He left there when he was 11. Maybe his parents had a British accent, so it just stuck. Because you would think if he moved to the U.S. when he was 11, he would have lost it. Of course, maybe he's just making it more pronounced when he raps because it's more fun. So this is a cautionary tale. You know, don't go out in the street and make trouble because look where you'll end up. No chorus either. It was just straight on storytelling, which is great. It was a great story. Well, it's called Children's Story, so. So hopefully those those kids, that was funny them talking. Hopefully those kids listen to their Uncle Ricky and understand to be good boys and girls. Well, thanks for voting for that, and thanks for hanging with me. If you guys like this kind of content, give me a like and a subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye.